Welcome back to our very special segment, Rebooting India. And joining us today is Siddharth Birla, President FICCI. Many thanks, Mr. Birla, for talking to us here on NDTV. Let me first start by getting your view on a very important development that's bound to have an impact on the economy as a whole. The coal auction process rules to be identified, notified, and detailed today, later today. How significant is this development, and what's the kind of spin-off impact it can have?
Thank you, Shweta. Of course, let us wait for the details to come out. But in our opinion, the speed at which the government has done this is quite commendable, because we had the court had given them time until 31st December to continue mining. And from FICCI's side, we had been suggesting that the problem is of a very grave magnitude on a multiple levels. You know, one is the availability of coal, then obviously the need to import coal, the necessity to get the projects which were otherwise stalled back into running. Otherwise, the amount of money that was tied up in these projects was having a bad financial effect on the banks, on the overall sentiment. So I think the fact that Mr. Goyal had suggested that it could be done within December is very heartening that the rules are going to come out today.
So, Birla, what's also important, as many experts point out, is to ensure that there is no aggressive bidding that takes place, because the sense that one has is that the coal auction will perhaps go the spectrum way. But the idea also to ensure that power tariffs as a result do not increase. So do you think the government needs to put in place these caveats to ensure that that we're not seeing the end consumer suffering as a result of this and power tariffs going up? Or do you think the reverse is true, that we need to start accepting that the days of cheap power are over?
Well, on one count, India is in the energy cost in India is globally uncompetitive, and tends to make our manufacturing uncompetitive. That is one part of the equation. But let me put it this way, that, you know, let us not try to double guess what a bidder will do and just bid like mad to get the coal block in the auctions. I think there is a certain amount of rationality that will obviously prevail with all the people who are going to bid. So I'm absolutely not trying to double guess how it will be bid. Secondly, I don't think that the government has revenue hunger in this auction process. The idea is to make sure that the allocations take place transparently, without discretion, and in a manner that the end result is achieved. That is, people don't take a auction, take a coal block and not actually mine it, use it. So I think the revenue hunger is not driving this auction process, and therefore I do not see bids which are not rational being put out.
Mr. Birla, there's almost a sense of deja vu here, because we saw exactly the same thing happen in the telecom space, which is now repeating in the coal space. You had the judiciary coming in saying that the process had not been transparent, the 2G scam, which finally resulted in the e-auction process being put in place, and now Coalgate, which finally resulting in an e-auction process being put in place. Overall, if we look at this trend, how important is it to send out that signal that, yes, India is now moving towards greater transparency in governance, greater transparency in rule making, and that being really set as a trend going forward, that this is the way forward as far as auction or as far as allocation of natural resources go?
I think you've answered the question yourself, Shweta. See, the same, you know, I don't think we should equate the 2G story and the coal story. They took place under very different circumstances.